Welcome to another session. In this session, I have a talk about what is umbilical cord, what is the meaning of umbilical cord, and what is the function of umbilical cord. But it is not necessary for higher secondary student, but little bit idea should have for higher secondary student. So let's start. What is umbilical cord? Such umbilical cord, also known as navel string, it also known as navel string because it attached with the navel of fetus. That's why it is known as the navel string. And such navel string, also known as birth cord, so newly hatched baby, which is connected with mother through such cord. That's why it is known as the birth cord. It also known as funiculus umbilicalis. It also known as funiculus umbilicalis. So it is also known as funiculus umbilicalis. So where it present? So let's see here at the fifth week of development of fetus. Suppose that this is the fetus, and fetus, it has at the lower side, it has two sac-like structure which connect with the primitive gut of the fetus. And these sac-like structure, one is the yolk sac, another is the allantois. Suppose that this is the fetus. This is the fetus, and this fetus, it is surrounded by another membrane which is known as the amnion. As you know, this is amnion, and the fluid is there in between the amnion and the fetus. This is known as the amniotic fluid. This is amnion. Outer two amnion, there is the outer extra embryonic membrane, and this membrane is known as chorion. Some part of the chorion which send out finger-like projection and enter into the endometrial wall of uterus. And these finger-like projection which enter into the uterus of mother, such finger-like projections are known as chorionic villi. Now such chorionic villi, it enter into endometrial wall of uterus. Suppose that this is the endometrial wall of uterus. So now the connection is formed because of the chorionic villi and the endometrial wall. So here the connection is formed. A relation is formed. This is the chorion, and these are the chorionic villi which enter into the endometrial wall of uterus. This is uterine wall. So it forms a connection in between fetus or in between chorion and the endometrial wall, and such connection is known as the placenta. This is known as the placenta. So at the development of during the fifth week of development, there is the gradual degradation of yolk sac. Yolk sac, this is the source of yolk or the nutrient. And allantois, it helps for the excretion process somehow. Allantois help for the excretion process of the fetus. This is fetus. This yolk sac, it also help for the production of RBC or the blood cells. So this is the placenta, And by the fifth week of development, there is the gradual degradation of yolk sac. At that time, the blood vessels appear. The blood vessels appear from placenta to fetus. From placenta to fetus. So there is one vein. There is one vein is developed. This vein supply. This vein supply oxygenated blood and nutrient blood to the fetus. To the fetus. So this is the vein which develops from the placenta. This is the vein which supply oxygen and nutrient rich blood to fetus. This is known as the umbilical vein. This is umbilical vein. Other two vessels also developed here. Suppose that this is the another blood vessels, and this is known as the artery. This is the artery. This is the artery. So there are two arteries are there. This is another artery. There is two artery is there. So there is two artery. There is two artery. So this is one and this is another one. This is the two artery. And these arteries are known as umbilical. This is the umbilical arteries. These artery carry out the blood from fetus to placenta. So deoxygenated blood carry away from the placenta through the umbilical arteries. So there is the three blood vessels, one vein and two arteries. And there is the remnant. There is the remnant form of yolk sac and the allantois. These things togetherly they form a cord-like structure. And such cord-like structure, this cord-like structure, now it is known as the umbilical cord. So this is known as the umbilical cord. This is known as umbilical cord. So this umbilical cord, which enter into fetus via abdomen. So it enter into fetus through abdomen at the region of navel. So after birth, after the separation of umbilical cord, this region which becomes umbilicus or navel, after separation of umbilical cord. If you take the section, then you find that, suppose that this is the umbilical membrane. This is the umbilical outer membrane. There is the one vein. Suppose that this is the vein. This is the umbilical vein, and there is two arteries. So this is the artery. The wall is thick. Suppose that this is the artery. These are the two umbilical arteries are there. And the remnant form of Alan Toyce also present, maybe here. So this is the Alan Toyce chord or Alan Toyc chord. Suppose that this is the Alan Toyc chord, and these blood vessels present inside the jelly-like structure, inside the gelatinous material, inside the gelatinous material. Such gelatinous material is known as Watton's jelly. This is known as Watton's jelly. This Watton's jelly provide protection to the blood vessels, means arteries and the vein. Such Watton's jelly, it is made up of mucopolysaccharide. It is made up of mucopolysaccharide. It is made up of mucopolysaccharides. So here the lining, the internal lining of umbilical membranes, which is mesenchymal epithelium. So internal lining, which is the mesenchymal epithelium. These are the mesenchymal epithelium. Such mesenchymal epithelium, it behave as a stem cell. So mesenchymal or the epithelial stem cell, nowadays they are required for the research and they are required for the transplantation. So this is the actual idea of the umbilical cord. So this is the umbilical cord, and there is the formation of blood vessels. So there are three blood vessels are there. If one vein, one artery is present, then such condition is known as the abnormal condition. So one vein and one artery present in case of abnormal fetus, but actually there are one vein and two arteries are there. One vein and two arteries should present in typical fetus. And there is the development of blood vessels. That's why it develops at the region of the placenta. That's why there is no mixing of blood of mother and the fetus. This umbilical cord, this is the part of the physiological and the genetical part of fetus and mother.